Hey there, TikTakers! Today, we'll be talking about a condition which affects many people around the world, and it's likely that you know someone who suffers from it. We are talking about alopecia, more commonly known as baldness. As many of you know, alopecia is the abnormal loss of hair. That detail is important because we all lose hair throughout our lives. To clarify this, let's explain the basics of what the normal cycle of hair growth looks like. It is divided in three stages. The first one is the growth stage, which lasts from 2 to 6 years. During that time, the hair grows about 1 centimeter per month. The second one is the resting stage, which lasts around 2 days. And the final stage is the falling stage, which lasts around 3 months. On average, we all lose from 70 to 100 hairs per day, TikTakers. Surprising, isn't it? Under normal conditions, those hairs that fall are replaced by new hairs produced by the hair follicles. Now, for those who might not be familiar with that term, it is important that we explain what exactly is a hair follicle. This is a part of the skin where hair grows thanks to its concentration of stem cells. Each hair grows from its own follicle, and each hair follicle follows its very own cycle. In other words, each hair follicle is independent from the rest, and thus each hair we have could be in a different stage of the growth cycle. Interesting, right? Now, if you're wondering how many hairs does someone without alopecia usually have, the answer is between 100,000 and 150,000 hairs. That's a lot, right? However, things obviously change when someone suffers from alopecia, although not all alopecia cases are the same, since there are different kinds of this condition. Surely most of you know that hair doesn't grow just on the head. Alopecia can also affect the eyelashes, armpits, beard, and other parts of the body. Again, there are different types of alopecia, but before naming them, we have to categorize them in two larger groups. On one hand, we have the scarring alopecias, where the hair follicles are completely destroyed, making this condition irreversible. On the other hand, we have the non-scarring alopecias, which are usually reversible. So even though several alopecia treatments exist, many types of alopecia are incurable nowadays. The most common form of alopecia is androgenic alopecia, also known as common baldness. This one constitutes 95% of alopecia cases, especially in men. Among the causes for this kind of alopecia, we can find a genetic component and a hormonal component. And even though it is much more common in men, it can also affect women TikTakers. Another type of alopecia is alopecia areata, where the hair loss isn't uniform, and instead it falls from specific areas, forming bald spots. That kind of alopecia is usually reversible, so the hair can be recovered. It is usually caused by stress, among similar causes. We can also find traumatic alopecia, and just like its name indicates, it occurs due to some sort of physical trauma. There is also diffused alopecia, which results in a general hair loss which can be mild or severe. In this kind of alopecia, the hair can usually be recovered and is produced by a severe illness, stress, or drastic weight loss. As you can see, there are many factors which can lead us to lose hair, and we want to help you become aware of how alopecia can affect anyone. Thus, if you ever see someone suffering from this condition, please don't point at them and stare at them as if they were freaks. Alopecia is pretty common, and in many instances, it can affect the emotional state of the one suffering from it. So we invite you to support people with this condition and help them see that whether they have hair or not, they are still the same person. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like it. And if you want to see more Draw My Life videos, subscribe to our channel. See you in the next episode!